open this. So for those of you who are wondering what just happened. Zombie, what happened to that? I'll tell you what happened. Literally, as I'm loading up Dying Light to play, internet crashes across the world. I mean, boom, it's gone. No internet. I'm like, what? So I have reboot the router, I have reboot the modems, I have reboot this, I have reboot my computer and everything, and now it looks like it's working. And now we are only about 30 minutes away from the Dying Light info video from coming out. Is the zombie getting frustrated? Yes. The zombie's getting very fucking frustrated. Looks like everything's up and running now. Waiting for this last screen to start working. Cool. Awesome. I'm going to go ahead and pop the white headphones on real quick. This is just so I can make sure volume's working when I do this. Bam. Bam. My fingers are crossed here. I don't hear any game audio, though. I don't know where this music's coming from.
The eyes of the world have been glued to the city of Haran for the past 2 months, following the outbreak of a previously unknown pathogen.
It is not yet clear what has caused this gruesome affliction. The local government's Ministry of Defense erected a quarantine wall shortly after the outbreak.
The global relief effort's steady stream of supply drops has sustained what few survivors remain in the city. The Ministry of Defense believes more radical action should be taken to stem the tide of this virus.
The question is, are there still non-infected survivors in the city as the GRE maintains? And if so, will the Ministry still go through with a stated plan to annihilate the city in an attempt to wipe out the Haran virus once and for all?
Whether by way of the virus or the Ministry's proposed plan... One thing is certain. Haran's days are numbered.
Hearing Dying Light. Not hearing Dying Light. What if I had to turn this one off? Hey, look, there's the announcement. Oh, wait a minute. I heard it there for a second. Let's go ahead and start playing real quick and see if we hear it. And we only got like... Yep, there we go. Okay, so cool. I hear it now. Something worked.
Jade just told me there's been an outbreak on the 18th floor. I've got to get what little antizen I have back to the tower pronto.
I think that delay is really bad on this. Again, if you wonder, well, the white headphones. Hold on, I'm trying to see what this is. For some reason, one of my... The white headphones are set up to this. Okay, yeah, see? Something's not working. Hold on.
Another night to survive. Will we live through it?
Okay.
It's dark as hell.
Let's see if we get volume now.
Oh, man. This means we can survive for the next couple of days at least. Thank you so much.
Okay, that's really quiet. So I'm really quick going to minimize. I'm going to turn this up to about there. We have a drop coming in. It's nighttime. Let's try to do that real quick. It's nighttime. We should have Heart Piercer and Dawn Light equipped. Drops just right over here. I am hearing like some bad feedback. And I can't hear the game at all. Try to sneak behind that guy. Spider-Man, my ass up. Oh, fuck! Come the fuck on! Okay, we made it to here. Right as the flare dies. Awesome. And we're dead. Okay, and I still can't hear the game. I'm hearing feedback like crazy. I wonder if the feedback is due to these headphones. Hold on. I'm going to pull. Okay, I'm watching my monitor here. Okay, starting 3, 2, 1. Okay. Yeah, it might just be that. Okay, but I'm still not hearing the game. Desktop audio up to there. Oh, shit. Hey, I think we got it. Yeah, there we go. It said the delay, I can actually hear it. Like, I've already opened these chests on my game. Still hearing a little bit of feedback. And again, I wonder if that is because of... these headphones being next to it. It's the only thing I can come up with right off the top of my head. And then I'm caught. So we're gonna do this real quick. Let's get up. This is a safe zone. I don't have to worry about getting killed. Okay, so I'm gonna mess with a couple of settings here. Move this out of my damn. Desktop audio down to about there. Okay, so desktop audio. This is really interesting stream, isn't it, guys? We've had nothing but failures. We've had nothing but, you know, complications. It's just one of them days. Now, this one here is my mic. It's just, I like it right about here. Stop streaming. Minimize this. Pull up this tech lamp page. We're going to see. Let's pull up a YouTube. This game, Raleigh, I'm going to go ahead and throw you up here again. Okay, I'm hearing it. So that works. And I'm seeing video. That. Okay. Right now, the only thing that should be picking up sound is my mic. See, I'm hearing it there. Let's try to mess with the mic. Let's see here. Mic. There's the mic. Let's see. Filters. Is that better? I think that's better. Nope. Nope. Not at all. Let's see here. Let's add. That's a noise gate. That noise suppression. Is that better? I think we got it. Cool. All right. Nice. Okay. Well, yeah. We are literally like 20 minutes away here. So let's see. I'm going to switch headphones here, and we'll play a little Dying Light for about 10 minutes. Let me know in the chat if that noise keeps coming up. Those white headphones are chat connected, as where these ones are not. Now, if you're wondering, Zombie, why you kind of angle yourself this way? Well, I am trying to watch this monitor and not the stream monitor, because like I was saying, there are some serious delay going on. Not as bad as it used to be with, like, slobs, so. Which again, yeah, so that might have been shit, that was stupid of me. If you were wondering why I switched, okay, so apparently, even though Streamlabs isn't open source, all open source kind of requires that, you know, you tell the people that you're using it. You know, so like, if I'm going to make my own version of Streamlabs using their open source coding, I give them, you know, props for it. Like, hey, yeah, this was used their coding as a base, I changed it, added this. Well, apparently, Slobs, Streamlabs OBS, never did that. In fact, they even went as far as copywriting a name that wasn't theirs. This is just a. over.
Hey, what are you looking for?
Something I can use for a tourniquet.
Anyways, yeah, so there's like this huge big thing where, like, you know, they basically have stolen and plagiarized their stuff from, you know, original Streamlabs. And I like OBS a lot better, mainly because it was one of those I used it first things. That was the one I really I learned all the stuff for. That's why today's stream a little sloppy. I haven't mastered all of the nuances of OBS yet. Why I'm just running them. We only got a few minutes before we're gonna cut to the live stream event. Live stream, gamer conference, whatever you want to call it. But anyways, so you can tell I've been playing some different first-person shooters because I tried to zoom in with my bow, which is usually left trigger for me. On this game, left trigger shoots my spider rope. Crap, but I call it the Spider-Man. Spider crane. So anyways, back to this. I forgot what I was saying. I know I was talking about OBS and Streamlabs. But yeah, that's why everything's been really kind of sloppy today. Oh no. When that happens, that's usually when I have that one on. It's weird because we turned in a bunch of. Whoa. Did I just. I just teleported in through a window. Interesting. Try to teleport out. Okay. Anyways, so other than that, like I said, I have been trying to avoid the spoilers for Dying Light 2. The only reason I'm going to do the Dying to Know today is because it's Dying to Know, and I've broadcasted every one of them. I'm going to keep broadcasting them all because I think it's awesome. And, you know, Dying Light 2 has officially gone gold, which maybe it's just because I'm a gamer, and I've been gaming since, you know, the beginning of gaming time. It's not really a joke, I have been gaming forever. But as soon as they said gone gold, I knew exactly what that meant. I actually had to explain that to a lot of people. So, for those of you who don't know, going gold in the gaming world means that at this point, there is no more game. They don't have to program anything, there's no more character models to make, nothing. The game is being printed onto physical discs. I am being ready for digital output, like, you know. Shit. Ow. Okay, we better use that first aid kit. Oh, for glasses. But anyways, like, Microsoft Store, PlayStation, and stuff like that. Steam. It's ready for that. So at this point, the only thing they would be working on as a development front would be the teams would be QA or QC, depending on what you want to call it, quality assurance, quality control, are playing the fuck out of it and doing like right now what I'm doing, just running around testing out like, hey, what happens if I jump here? What happens if I fall through this? Will I go through a curtain? You know? And they're getting all that stuff ready for, you know, everyone's favorite day one patch. What it means for us is that the game is now out of the developer's hands for the most part. It is in production. And they are printing discs, getting it ready for shipping and distribution. Which means we, getting closer, 2 months away. At this point, they really can't delay the game other than we can't get copies shipped anywhere because of the shipping shortage right now in the U.S. and worldwide. You know, it is a worldwide thing. Ooh, I missed that one.
Oh.
I've been playing so many different FPS games. My controls are just all sorts of fucked in my head. where are we at time? We got about 9 minutes left. Also a little rusty here because last time I played this, which was only a couple days ago, there was the hyper event, which if that video you saw at the intro when we first started about an hour ago, was one of those, you know, kill everybody using your feet and hands only, which I got my 100 plus. Actually, I think I got close to 200.
Alone when I hear this. Oh. Noise.
Hey, assholes.
What is this shit? Now you're mad, huh?
Alright, so he's captured. There's my sword. Around here. You trying to watch the clock over there? Got about 2 minutes, so we're going to take a quick break while we switch over to the stream. And we'll probably end right after the Dying to Know, since, you know, the stream was supposed to... I thought I screwed up. I read the times wrong, which is my bad. We've got just a couple of minutes here. Sucks as I'm just starting to get back to my controls. Bam! Right in your face. Yeah, this gun's better for use at night. But... Oh! Blood fountain. I love this gun. I normally don't like using the guns in this game. I don't think they're realistic to have a gun in the zombie apocalypse. A little more realistic in this one. I'm glad they're not going to have a lot in the second one. Much to a lot of people's dismay. Just because you wouldn't have guns when it's broken down as far as it has in that part. Alright. To the safe zone. That's right away. That's what we're gonna call this game today. Like I said, we're gonna take a quick break.
Want a deal?
We. Okay. Okay. I can disconnect this and this. We're probably not gonna come back to playing any games after we're done with, this year. So,
that down. Go ahead and pull this up. Alright, so we will be back in a few minutes. I do have to set these headphones on. I'm going to use the restroom. Streams are getting low. Oh, wait, I got another one. I'm going to use the restroom anyways, but I should be back before that. In the meantime, jump and say hi, chat. Oh, I'm in the bathroom. You hear the alarm go off. I apologize. I'll be in the bathroom soon. Make no mistake. here? Does that work better? Okay, cool. Right, minute 43. Alright, well, during that minute, I want to really quick and talk about, starting... That's really loud now. We're gonna have to figure out this mic stuff as we go. I'll try to stay back from the mic. A little bit. There we go. Anyways, what I was gonna say is, since it is the holiday season, various holidays... Wow, that's really loud. Okay, hold on, that's way too loud. Let's try right there. Okay, that sounds about better. Anyways, it is the third day of Hanukkah, I believe. So, happy Hanukkah to everybody. I will be doing more holiday-themed zombie killing. Dying Light will be doing their thing here pretty soon, so I will be playing the fuck out of that community event. Killing Floor 2 always has their Christmas, which we'll go into later. And, yeah, so that'll be it. So basically, and then my new schedule is basically going to be Tuesdays through Fridays. I haven't set the times yet. I'm thinking either like 2 to 4 p.m. or 1 to 4 p.m. I haven't decided yet. I'll let you know as I work on it. All right, so right now we're at 2 seconds. Here we go.
Hi, welcome to the fifth episode of Dying to Know. I'm Jonah, and this is... Leah? No, it's not Dying Light 2, because that ain't out yet.
No, it isn't.
But just, you are playing a game, though.
This is a surprise I'll reveal right at the end of the episode, because it's Techland's 30th anniversary, so it won't be the only one.
I can tell you what that is. I can tell you what that is. I know what that is.
Don't go anywhere.
I won't, but can we get this show on the road, please?
Go on then, let's begin. This time we've prepared something very, very unique and I just can't wait to show it.
That's true. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we will show you fresh news about Techland GG, sum up the Dying Light 2 global preview events, which took place a few weeks ago, and most importantly, a 15-minute walkthrough video straight from Dying Light 2 Stay Human.
So if you want to see how the game looks 2 months before the release, stay with us. In the meantime, or just after the show, don't forget to go to dl2.dyinglightgame.com and pre-order it.
Just to make sure you can enjoy Dying Light 2 Stay Human on release on the 4th of February, 2022. That's something I'm going to do.
Me too, Jonah. Me too.
No, you're not. You guys
got
free copies.
So we're starting with some fantastic news. Dying Light 2 Stay Human is almost ready, and a while ago, some journalists and content creators from around the world had a chance to spend a few hours in front of their PCs or PS4s to play the latest version of the game. We held an event in the UK. I know, because I was there.
And in the US, where I was.
And there was also one in Russia.
Japan.
And of course, Poland.
Now, even though those countries are completely different, the outcome was
lucky,
exactly the
lucky
same.
Bastards.
People loved the game. Let's see what it looked like. Having seen that, we can't imagine not showing the game to you guys as well. Senior producer of Dying Light 2 Stay Human, Cornel Yaskula, will take us right into the city in a Dying Light 2 gameplay video like none other before. You ready?
Hey, Cornel.
Hi.
Welcome to the show. So, before we talk about the gameplay, which I know we're dying to get into, I want to talk about the preview events we've had. So, what did people who played the game for the very first time have to say about it?
Maybe, you know, it's not too humble for the dev to say, but they really love it. They love Dying Light to Stay Human. And after the events, they gave us really honest feedback about the game. And it's really, really helping us polishing the game at the very stage of the production.
I mean, yeah, because you've only got about 2 months now until final release. There's a lot of polishing to get done in a short amount of time.
And as someone who voices the main character in the game, do you guys know that?
Voice Angel? Well,
yeah, I'm wondering, was this filmed before?
I'm pretty sure. I was also at the preview event in San Francisco, and I have with me a few quotes from the media and content creators trailers, and they are overwhelmingly positive. Let's start. The parkour gameplay still is very unique and is implemented well into the open world design. Way to go. The action is intense, the scale of the world is impressive, and the feel of traversal is an overall improvement over what has come before, particularly in the way the game builds and expends momentum, and the characters seem like the real strong point. Varied, engaging, and interesting. So, way to go. Kudos to you guys.
Yeah, that is some fantastic feedback. I mean, congrats to you and the Dying Light 2 team.
Thank you.
So, we are going to be seeing some gameplay here in just a second. Mm-hmm. Now, where are we going? What are we doing in the city?
So this quest takes place somewhere around one third of the story. Aiden is trying to get more details about his missing sister, and he leaves Old Villador and comes to the Central Loop when he's trying to get to the, to here, to Fisheye Canteen.
So what's the difference between Old Villador and the Central Loop? Is there any difference?
Interesting. There is. There are completely different settings. While Old Villador is traditional, full of traditional buildings, this is the oldest part of the city. The Central Loop is full of skyscrapers, office buildings, so Aiden has to start using his paraglider. And of course, there are plenty of places connected to open world facilities.
Okay, cool.
Okay, so I mean, aside from trying to get to the familiar Fisheye Canteen, what is our overarching goal for this quest?
It starts with a truly spectacular view, the city coming back to life. But then suddenly something goes wrong, and we need to help Lawan fix that. It's a great opportunity to see how the city alignment system works in more detail, to get a glimpse of a complex story and dynamics between the characters.
Still wondering about the city alignment.
Enough of me talking, really, and let's just watch the gameplay.
Damn it. I was wrong.
Yeah, let's watch this, guys.
Can't see shit. I really thought it'd work. You were fucking duped.
If you don't know, that's Rosario Dawson.
At least it's peaceful.
Yep. That's why I come here when I'm pissed off. So a lot, believe me. Look! Aiden! They're back on! You see that again? You see that? It's beautiful. Oh, I can't believe it. No, I just can't believe it.
That's actually really cool.
I see it, Danyar. I'm at a lookout point, and it's quite the show.
How does half a dark as hell for 15 years and suddenly this?
I don't know. Don't know. But we need to find out.
Then drop by the canteen and let's talk. Been missing you like last year's snow loca.
While shotgunning beers and screwing bartenders.
You know me. It's a gift.
We'll meet you there, dumbass.
Something's wrong.
No. Oh, no, 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 no! No! Fuck! What the hell's going on?
So that's the fish shot. Okay, how do we get there?
Fisheye's gotta wait.
Gotta wait? But why?
We need to check the substations. One's over there, level with the PK tower.
What about the Fisheye?
Listen, I want to help you, and I will help. We'll do this together.
This is really interesting.
But you have to understand.
I'll go into it afterwards.
It's the first. It's been the same situation for over 10 years. 10 years of this fucking darkness. We gotta check this out.
How do we get to the substation?
It's an old paraglider. It'll help you get to places you normally can't reach. Just follow me.
Wait!
Fuck.
This paraglider, can it be made to fly faster?
Possibly. But that's something you should ask the Prospector about.
It's pretty smooth parkour. Looks like they fixed the landing, so that looks more solid when he lands.
Those paragliders? It used to be a Night Runner's favorite toy.
You a Night Runner?
Me? Night Runner? I wish.
Oh, look at all those.
Oh! Blood fountains, come on! Blood fountains!
Oh. Do this. I can't wait to kill things in this game. I mean, this paragliding shit, honestly, I'm not too excited about. But we'll see how it turns out. It may actually be the funnest part. I may end up loving it. Oh, you're ugly. Oh, and here we go. See, it may end up being really fun paragliding. The Walking Dead. I like that. There's a little Easter egg for y'all right there. Which, if you know me and Easter eggs and Dying Light, I will find all of them.
Hey,
there's gonna be
you.
A big guy in there.
Seen any signs of renegades around here?
No.
See, Private? Now calm down and let Aglot think.
What's there to think about? Why not head back to base?
Who the heck are you, anyway?
I'm someone offering to help. I'll check what happened to the power. You know anything else about it?
That's top secret military information.
We're trying to figure out how to get up there.
Just go ahead and tell him everything, why don't you? Every last detail.
Well, what's the big secret, huh? We need to get this piece of shit working, that's what.
My colleague's vastly oversimplifying things, but his gist is correct. There are obvious signs of the electricity having returned, and this here appears to be a substation. It and others like it are capable of transmitting electricity throughout the city. We have orders to get this building functioning once more.
Meaning, turn it back on.
Unfortunately, without climbing equipment, access to it is severely limited.
So I can climb up there without
dialogue?
The equipment.
You'd be willing to do that? You'd be doing a great favor for the peacekeeper.
Uniform! Take that! Electricity brings all the fights up!
What was that?
It sounds like Borderlands bandits.
And a goat.
PK morons! We'll be taking that electricity! Thank you very much! Kill him!
Here! Swing and a miss! Oh! That was a nice blow. I don't know why all this is happening. Oh! Oh!
I would surmise the main circuit suffered a break. Find a cable and connect the source of power to the transmitter. That should restore the circuit.
Yep, I'm on top of the substation, trying to connect the power to the transmitter.
It wasn't a piece of cake in here, after all. Sure you
I met a bunch of PKs who couldn't get to the substation themselves.
So that's why you haven't called me yet.
You should see them. Decide which one I like more.
You know that'll cost you, right?
Some long ass cable. Ooh, and then you get to choose. Car traps, bring in power, or airbags. Fuck. Holy shit. That's very old RTS capture the area shit happens.
Are you pissed at me?
I like that. I like that.
And I know why. But if it were me, I'm for the free folk all the way.
I don't understand.
There are a lot more substations.
I guess
you we could get us all going.
Can we first go to the fisheye and...
Yeah, sure. Let's meet in the canteen. I'll wait for you there.
These paragliders, they look fun.
Fever, hurt, diarrhea. You're on your own, friend.
Pilgrim, take my advice. Leave this city.
Frank is one handsome fella. It's a shame he's such a booze hound.
Well? Frank!
They slaughtered us, one by one, like fucking rabbits.
Frank? Frank, it's me. Wake up!
You? What the fuck you doing here? Interrupting my conversation with...
Ravik's been dead for years, Frank. Pull yourself together. You got a visitor.
And who's that? Queen of fucking England? I gotta act all dainty now?
This is Aiden. He has the GRE access key. Waltz used it to turn on the electricity in town.
Working GRE key? You're full of shit.
Show it to him.
Where'd you get it?
From one of Waltz's men.
So you want one of Waltz's men too?
Hey, easy, Frank. Aiden is on our side. We think this contains data proving what they did to us in the hospital.
So you still believe you'll find out why Waltz fucked up your childhood? Okay, I'll tell you. Ready? Because he's a fucking psycho. He's fucked in the head. That's your holy
so
grail.
I want to know now.
The covenant all in one, Luan. Happy? Aiden, right? You and Luan can get the fuck out of my face now.
You hear that? Fuck. Something's happening. Will you check? I'm right behind you.
I'm sure. I've seen them.
Renegades in the Central Loop? Nonsense!
To all units, Renegades are in the Central Loop. I repeat, Renegades are in the center. They're surrounding the fisheye.
Oh,
can
shit.
Anyone hear me? Over.
Give me that bow. That's what I want. I want that bow right there. Those spears are pretty cool looking. Give me a bow. I will shoot every one of these. Oh, he knocked his mask off. I love that. That.
They put a cannon on a nearby building. To the east. Aiden, one more hit will destroy the fisheye. Hurry!
This is cool here. I like this. Different systems to just kind of fly all over. Oh. Grapple him off the building. Grapple him off the building. Come on, come on. Yes! Yes! Make the Batman fly! Oh!
Well, that was close.
Aiden! More renegades on the lower level.
Seriously, I I want a bow and arrow. I like all these melee weapons, but give me a bow and arrow. Oh, that was nice, though. I do like electrocution. Oh, threw his ass in fire. Nice. Threw that spear. There we go. There's the bow and arrow. That was a blood fountain. Oh, there's one on the ground. Can't tell if he got that one in time, or if he just moved it up so it would shoot over. Yeah, less than a minute to take out three assholes. And you're gonna try running away. Nah. Throw rocks at me. There you go. At least you'll be working on the objective while getting. I like that bullet time thing that happened. Oh shit. Off that building. Oh shit. Hurry up. Oh, he did it.
They're inside the fisheye. They have Frank. They blocked the door. I can't get in.
Ah, shit. I'm on my way. Hurry up, wait. One, two.
Drop him.
One move and he dies.
Drop him.
Oh!
Aiden, what?
Wow, so there's a lot of story packed into that. So are people who haven't played Dying Light 1 gonna understand what's going on in Dying Light 2?
Of course. Action in the city takes place more than 20 years after the original game. It's a completely new hero, completely new city, so we made sure about that. So people that haven't played the original game will still enjoy this one.
Okay,
All right, well, back to the gameplay. Right. We saw loads of really cool parkour and combat moves there. Mm. Pretty sure at one point we saw Aiden vaulting over his enemies.
Yeah, and I saw monkey bars, and at some point he was swinging on a rope?
There are many, many more. Twice as many as in Dying Light 1, to be specific. And did you notice some of the new combat moves?
Oh, yeah.
So we tackled an enemy, make them fall, there were ground pounds, perfect dodges, perfect tackles, and yes, those are only examples of what you are able to do in the game. Not to mention the grappling hook or other tools that has its own special place inside the combat loop.
Right, yeah, I mean, there's a lot to be excited about. You've got the paraglider, which looks incredible, and then like the city alignment system.
Yeah, and weapon mods, and I don't know if it was just me, but I'm pretty sure Aiden was stronger and faster and more agile.
Yes, he did. As I said before, this quest takes place further in the story, so we've already acquired a paraglider.
Right. Mm-hmm.
We also develop our character enough to unlock new abilities on both skill trees dedicated to parkour and the combat. And it's up to you how you're going to spend those skill points. Is it going to be stronger Aiden or more agile Aiden in the end?
Huh. Right, of course, because I mean, we have skill trees in Dying Light 1, but I'm interested to see how those evolve and change in Dying Light 2.
New game offers new possibilities for us. So we added plenty of new stuff to the game, but of course we had a very strong base to begin with.
Yeah.
We built on top of that, added even better parkour, better combat, complex story, and we mixed that with the unique setting of modern Dark Ages.
Right.
Mm, wow, thank you so much, Cornel, for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, and if you want to see more about the items, the things we've just mentioned here, then why not pre-order and play the game for yourself when it comes out on the 4th of February, 2022.
The old man got hit by a rock tied to a rope. It hit his head, causing him to fall to the ground. There was blood everywhere. Though in the dim light of the almost burnt out fire, all there was darkness. He grabbed his head, one eye bloody. Troy was hit with yet another arrow, this time in the abdomen. Still he stood, though with every second weaker and weaker. They were helpless, and Alyssa knew it was her time to stand up for them.
Wait, what happens next?
I wouldn't want to spoil it for you. That was an excerpt from a submission to our UGC contest.
You guys are so talented. Please keep sending in your art, your cosplay, and your stories. And you might win some rewards.
There's cosplayers out there reposting guidelines, so
you can cosplay the characters from Dying Light 2 even more accurately.
You'll find more at our website, dyinglightgame.com/contest. And if you find any of our official assets, you're welcome to cosplay the characters from those as well. So go to the page and let your creativity flow.
We're waiting until January 10th, so please make sure you submit.
Remember our Techland GG program? It's getting better and better. We've added something that will help you prepare for Dying Light 2 Stay Human now. In-game actions.
Love this.
There's special achievements you activate on the website and complete in-game to get experience points and earn levels in the program. And new Techland GG levels mean rewards to claim in Dying Light and soon weapons in Dying Light 2 Stay Human.
On this morning.
Meaning you'll have a head start on exploring the city on release.
And because we made leveling and claiming goodies simpler and clearer for all of you, Techland GG is better than ever. Well, thank you for today, and we'll see you next time. I'm just gonna go back to my game now. That's all right. Bye!
Whoa, wait. I thought you were gonna tell me why you were playing some sort of Wild West shooter. What was it?
Some sort of Wild West shooter. That was Call of Juarez, partner. And it's Techland's famous Western franchise. And it's a great moment to remind people about it, as well as other Techland games, since the company's celebrating the 30th anniversary.
Oh, that's right. Happy birthday, Techland! So many titles, I don't know where to start.
I mean, we've already mentioned Call of Juarez, so, I must say, traveling through the Wild West deserts and towns, shooting your way through inbound in blood, and hunting down legendary outlaws in Gunslinger. Really,
Dead Island and Dead Island.
Remember Crime Cities? It's one of the first ones. Hard to believe it's already been 21 years since the release.
I mean, how can you forget? It's a classic.
Yeah, flying that car across that sci-fi city, that was so much fun.
I mean, and of course, we have to mention Dying Light. Mm. It's been almost 7 years since we first visited Harran, and there's still so much new stuff happening there. All the new updates, DLCs, events, and not to mention the Nintendo Switch port that got launched a few weeks ago. We're happy you can still enjoy everything to do with Dying Light 1, and kind of just want to go play it myself.
Well, we will. We definitely will after the show. But first, isn't there some more surprises you're supposed to reveal?
Maybe. Yeah. To celebrate the 30th birthday, we partnered with GOG and Steam to let you grab some of our earlier games for free.
Head to GOG for your free copy of Crime Cities, and a week later, check Steam for Call of Juarez Gunslinger.
And remember to go to Techland GG, because Techland's 30th anniversary means we're having
even
more gifts and
offers
for you.
Some free shit for you.
For the next 2 weeks, all activities there will give you double experience points. So make sure you don't miss up that chance to level up faster.
Nice.
And that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed watching one of the Dying Light 2 Stay Human quests with us. And remember, it's just about 8 weeks now until release.
So make sure to wishlist the game or go to dl2.dyinglightgame.com and click pre-order to get your copy of Dying Light 2 Stay Human and a set of awesome exclusive skins.
I think that's all we've got to say. Remember to stay human, and we'll see you soon.
All right, I think that was it, guys. Not bad for our fifth stake. Let's close that down. There we go. Why hasn't the music stopped yet? Let's wait. Okay, there we go. All right, we're going to go visit Techland. Hey, look, yeah, they updated stuff. All right, so yeah, this got updated since this morning. Because, I come in every day and I check to level up.
Ooh, get reward merch discounts. Ha. Oh. But anyways, so let's check out these new. Well, hold on. Before we do that, let's see here. What the? Okay, I will be taking care of these. Let's see here. Oh yeah, we're just gonna go ahead and throw that right there. I know I already am. Okay. Rewards. Claim. Save that right there and claim. Did they change the reward system? I think they did. Tier 1, level 2. They did. They changed it because I was already... Anyways, here. I'm going to leave this up for a second. Go ahead and if you want to copy that code, I'm going to copy it and throw it on Facebook. The risk of opening. Okay. So yeah, they changed stuff as of to. I'm confused because yeah, seriously, they had, you know. Okay, there, I just claimed that one. Okay, so now by these point systems here, I should be like up here, right? No, that's 10,000. So let's go back. I'm sorry, this is confusing because this morning, the old reward system was a lot of, see, there's the dying light. I already had the last hope. See, last hope right there. I got it back in September. Because seriously, I was level 10 or 11, but I'm at only a... This is kind of cool and pissing me off at the same time. Oh, well. All right. Well, we're going to go ahead and minimize this. All right, everybody. Well, thank you for stopping by. Apparently, we're about an hour stream today. Sorry for all the technical problems. We've apparently gotten it kind of figured out. Volume's still a little loud on this mic. Let's... drop it to here. Sorry, I paused so I could catch up to that. There, it's not as loud. Okay. So anyways, yeah, we will be back tomorrow. Like I said, I don't know if it's going to be 1 or 2 o'clock. I'm still working on the time frames. Knocking out these rewards and shit if I haven't already done it today. And hopefully no technical problems tomorrow. Fingers crossed. All right. Oh, and I did want to mention those things real quick. So during that whole thing. Okay, so one, I noticed I got rid of the health bars. Which was a big thing a lot of people were complaining about. Let's see if this helped, by the way. Now it's too far out. Maybe there? Check. Now watch, I killed my mic. No? it's working. Okay. So anyways, yeah, a lot of people were complaining during one of the releases earlier that there were health bars with the enemies and the monsters. Looks like they got rid of those. Looks like they got rid of the complete HUD, though, and I don't know if I like that. Again, the paragliders look interesting. Until I play them, though, I'm going to be skeptic on that. And what I said about when the power came back on and it blew off, and they're like, oh, what happened? When mass power outage happens, all your lights, your blenders, your TVs, everything that were on at that time are still plugged in and on. So when the power kicks back on, it can blow shit because it's so much power drawn instantly. So that's probably what they should have been looking into. I mean, they would have to restart the substation. I don't know how they got those long-ass wires, because like that one he took from that floor up and over to that floor. I don't know. We'll be checking it out. All right, everybody. Well, thank you for stopping by during this crazy and messed up technical issued stream with some great info today. I'm going to go figure out this new Techland screen because I'm a little mad that it seems like my points went away. In the meantime, anyone, everybody, you know, be safe out there. Again, happy Hanukkah to those who celebrate Hanukkah. And as always, wash your hands, wash your face, wash your butts. Much love from the zombie. I'll see y'all later.